Do you struggle with your times tables? Well, get ready, because you're about to smash that problem for good with something completely new that you've never seen before. You won't find anything like this anywhere else. I'm going to be walking you right through my simple three-step process and each of my picture stories to show you exactly how every one of them works. You can use these to solve all of the basic problems in all of your times tables, but you'll also discover how to use them to go way beyond those problems and solve much larger multiplications in your head too. Hello, internet friends. I'm Lee Cook, the guy they call the Numba Ninja. So this video is in response to a question from Jasmine251, who asked, "My son gets so upset with times tables and it's really holding him back. I hated these when I was at school, but it's even worse watching him suffer like this. When he goes to bed in tears, I end up crying too because I really feel his pain. I've seen some of your videos and your approach looks like it could really work for him, but I don't know where to get started. Please, can you help?" Thanks, Jasmine. I know that pain, and this video is going to really help you. Try watching this video with your son. So here we go. This is how it works. It's a simple three-step process. The first step with any multiplication is to spot the fastest key to solving the problem. It'll be one of the numbers in the problem or the X in the middle. My system teaches you how to do that easily. The second step is to link the key you chose to its special picture, which, as you'll see, is really easy too. And lastly, you just use the story related to the picture to get quickly and easily to the answer. Now, if you've not already seen any of my videos about those simple picture stories, be sure to check those out either right here on this channel or the more detailed ones over on my number.ninja website. You'll see how with just a few stories you can multiply many problems, and I'm not just talking about those up to 12 times 12. You can use these for many problems way beyond that. Let me show you some examples. Let's start with 10 times 9. You'll learn it's much quicker to multiply by 10 than by 9. So we choose 10 as the key. Now the picture for 10 is a snail. Can you see how that snail looks like a 10? Well, all of my pictures have an easy link like that. Next, we play the snail story in our heads using the other part of the problem, the 9. So in our story, the 9 is a snail who lost his shell. So we just need to pop one on. We pop a 0 on the end to make 90, 90. That's our answer. Of course, the snail works for any whole number as large as you like. For another example, let's try 11 times 12. You'll learn that 11 is the fastest key here, as the 11 story is quicker than the 12 story. The picture for the 11s is the sandwich. Do you see how that sandwich looks like an 11? Like I said, there's always an easy link like that. And so for step 3, the story we run in our mind is to make a sandwich using the other part of the problem, the 12. It goes like this. We put the 1 and 2 on the slices, and then, for a filling, we add 1 and 2 together to get 3. So we have 1, 3, 2. Our answer is 132. If you've ever tried to memorize the 11 times table, then you may have thought that 11 times 12 was hard to memorize. But you've just seen why you don't even need to remember it. And yes, it'll work for 11 times 11 as well. You break the two ones apart and you add them together to make a filling of 2, giving you 1, 2, 1. 121. In fact, it'll do a whole lot more too. You see, most of those kids at the top of your class may have no problem remembering those answers up to 12 times 11, but they're often stumped by problems like, say, 11 times 53, which you could now work out in a flash in your head, even if you never saw that problem before in your life. In step 1, you'd spot that 11 is the key. In step 2, you'd remember that the 11 looks like a sandwich. And in step 3, you'd simply make a sandwich using the 5 and 3 on those two slices of bread. The story leads you to simply create the filling to put in the middle by adding those two numbers together. Go on, why don't you see if you can do that right now and pop your final answer down in the comments below. And don't cheat. I mean, feel free to check your answer on a calculator after you've done this in your head. But notice how much longer it'll take you to do that compared to just looking at the problem and calling out the answer. You see, running up these three simple steps is quicker to do than fetching your calculator to work it out for you. Of course, you can also make a sandwich very easily with those smaller numbers up to 9. The easiest way to think about those is to just put that number on both slices of bread and forget about making a filling. It doesn't really matter with any of these problems if you don't choose the fastest key, as you'll still get the right answer anyhow. But I show you how to choose the fastest key, as you'll get to that answer quicker. For example, you've seen how the snail works for 10s and how the sandwich works for 11s. So which one would you use if you had to do 10 times 11? Would you find it faster to do that snail story and put a 0 on the end of 11 to get 110? Or would it be faster to make a sandwich with 1 and 0 on those two slices and then adding them together to put another 1 in the filling? You see, you still get to 110, but the snail was much faster. Now, we've looked at the 10s and 11s just so you can see how my system works. And it's just as easy to use this system with those so-called harder tables too, like the 6s, 7s and 8s, which we'll be looking at next. But before I move on to those, I want you to fully grasp how these three simple steps make my system unique. You see, if you're trying to memorize answers, you're trying to jump straight from the problem to the answer by memory, and that only works after you've memorized all those answers. With this system, you just take those three simple steps each time, and they lead you straight to the answer, even for problems you've never handled before. And then, for the ones that you keep coming across, you end up remembering a lot of the answers anyhow. So this is a great way to get those answers into your head quickly and easily, so that you can leap up those steps if you want to. But this way, you'll always have those steps to fall back on in case you're not completely sure of your answer. Do you see how this makes it really easy for you to master these problems without having to memorize those dreadful tables? So far, I've shown you my three simple steps and two of my picture stories. That gives you a quick overview of how my system works. And if you're still watching right now, you're probably wondering how this would work for some of those tables that are much harder than the 10s and 11s. So we're going to dive right into those. Up next, I'm going to show you how to use my musical note picture story when multiplying by 6. Then we'll have a look at some of those other nasty tables like the 7s and 8s, which many people dread, but you'll be amazed at how easy all of these are with this system. I'll pop a link to that next part of this video series somewhere on this screen at the end, as soon as it's ready. But if you're watching this video before that link shows up, it's because that video's still being edited, which would mean it's not quite ready for you yet. But be patient, I'll be uploading that next part very soon, as it's the very next one in this video series I've been recording for you. So be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell to be alerted as soon as it goes live. Do you see how simple and powerful these steps and stories are? You may have come across some methods like this sandwich before, but this is the first time you'll see a complete set of pictures that cover the whole of your times tables and beyond. And it's also the first time you'll find a system that uses these three simple steps to help you quickly choose which story to run with. Now, you've only seen a couple of those picture stories so far, and the rest are short and sweet just like these two. Can you see yourself using a system like this to get really good at multiplication without all the effort it takes to memorize those tables? And remember, you can use these to solve all of the basic problems in all of your times tables, but you'll also discover how to use them to go way beyond those problems and solve much larger multiplications in your head too. So, what's coming up? I'm going to be showing you how to crush any multiplication up to 12 times 12 without memorizing any of those terrible tables of answers, so you can kick that problem right out of the park for good. I'm going to show you how to multiply way beyond 12 times 12 in your head using the exact same system. I'm going to be walking you right through my simple three-step process and each of my picture stories to show you exactly how every one of them works. And I'll be telling you how you can get to play my Numba Ninja game with me right here on YouTube for free during some live stream coaching sessions. I'm super excited about this because I get a real kick out of helping people like you. I'm just really excited about this opportunity for you to get really good with numbers. And I'm excited to be here for you, to be able to help you out like this so that you can become a number ninja yourself.